First, let us understand what MPPD is, multiple particle dosimetry. See, multiple particle dosimetry is a model. Basically, it's a computational model that can be used for estimating human and laboratory animal inhalation particle dosimetry. Say, for example, that if there is a room of this sort, a human being continuously keeps on inhaling the surrounding air. What all particles are mixed up with the air gets into our lungs. Now we are doing the MPPD model in order to analyze the inhalation of human being, or it can be tested on a laboratory animal like a rat or a rabbit. That is usually done because of human ethicality point of view. Any medical examinations cannot be directly performed on a human being. It has to be priorly performed on an animal before a drug is released into the market. That is the usual procedure that is followed. Right? So, when it comes to part, the MPPD model, it calculates the deposition and clearance of monodispersed and polydispersed aerosols in the respiratory tracts of laboratory animals and human adults and children for particles ranging from very ultra-fine level of 1 nanometer to 1 pore to the coarse up to 100 microns. Right? Next, particles. These models are based upon, it has got two approaches basically. First one is a single path approach and the second one is a multiple path approach. In the first model, the single path approach, it is used for tracking airflow and calculating aerosol deposition in the lung. Whereas the respiratory tract dosimetry models have been developed for several laboratory animals. As I was saying, it is developed for rats, mouses, rhesus monkeys, pigs and rabbits. Next, dosimetry. It has got two approaches. First one is a single path approach and the second one is a multi-path approach. In the single path approach, it's a typical path where the airway generation is calculated. Next, in a multi-path method, it calculates the particle deposition in all the airways, including the lungs, and it provides a specific, lobar specific and air specific information. Data. This is the deposition fraction visualization. This is the image of the lung that has been obtained. There are five areas of the lung that has been taken into account. Those will be explained in the subsequent plot. See, we can see that the graph starts, like the plot has got colors ranging from blue to red, with blue as the zero value and red has taken the maximum value, 6.67 into 10 to the power of minus 4. This one is a multiple path particle dosimetry model and it is a stochastic model for a human lung. See, this is the graph that has been generated last night at 9:43 p.m. Particularly when we were sitting in the Taramani guest house. This is a direct graph that has been obtained from the software. And we have taken the following parameters into account, which can be seen in the next slide. On the abscissa, we have plotted the lobes, and on the ordinate, we have plotted the deposition fraction. So, this is left upper, left lower, right upper, right medium, and right lower. These are the five lobes that are taken into account when we are plotting the graph. It is observed that right lower has got the highest deposition fraction. These are the observations. And there's one more Excel sheet where one more graph is present. From this graph is 19 microns. It might not have been the exact value, or some calculation errors or units might not have been taken correctly. So, but the logic and the formula what we are using.